Welcome to another hands-on lesson. In this lesson, we're going to create an Amazon EFS file system and mount it to two instances across two availability zones. Now remember that the EFS file systems are mounted to Linux instances and we'll need to run some commands on Linux. The first one here is where we make a mount point. This is a directory on the Linux instance to which we will mount the file system. Then there's a couple of ways that we can install the utilities we need and mount the file system. The first is using the standard NFS client. And for that, we would install the NFS utils and then run this command. Now this command specifies the file system, some parameters, and then in red here, we can see the DNS name for the file system and it gets mounted to the mount point. That means that if you write some files to this location, you will see those written to the EFS file system. Now the other way, and what we're going to do, is to use the AWS EFS utils. For that, we install the Amazon EFS utils package, and then we use the mount helper command to actually mount the file system. And that's what we're gonna do when we're ready to mount our file system. So let's head over to the console. I'm in the EC2 management console, and first what we're going to do is create a security group and then our instances. I'm going to click on Create Security Group, call this one EFS Access, and add the same into the description. It can stay in the default VPC. For inbound rules, we'll need to manage our instances using SSH, and I'll need to allow that from anywhere. Now, I do need to add another rule for EFS, but at this point, I won't be able to do it the way I want to. I'll show you what I mean. If I type NFS before the network file system, we get the port range specified, but what I want to do is I want to secure it to the security group itself. And I can't see the security group. When I type SG, I can see other security groups in here, but I can't see the ID of this security group. So I can't do that one yet. What I have to do is create the security group. Then we're going to run edit inbound rules, add a new inbound rule, again type NFS, protocol is correct, and then let's type SG. This time we can see the group. This security group will be attached to our instances, but it will also be attached to the file system. And this rule we've just added will allow inbound traffic on the NFS port from the instances that have this security group attached. So let's click on Save Rules. That one's done. Let's go to Instances, and it's launched two instances. Now what I'm going to do is use the Linux 2 AMI, so defaults there, T2 micro, don't need a key pair, that's fine. We're going to select an existing security group. We're going to choose EFS access. And the only other thing I want to do is click on edit and select my subnet. This one will go into US East 1A. And that's basically it. Let's just launch that instance. Then we're going to go back, launch a second instance, and it will have the same settings, except it's going to be in US East 1B. So let's add the security group, come into subnet, and there's 1B there. Okay, so they're in different subnets. And that's it, the instances are launching. Great, so let's go over to EFS and create our file system. So I'm gonna search for EFS, open it up in a new tab, and this is the console page for EFS. And all we need to do here is simply create a file system. We can optionally give it a name. I just call it My EFS File System. We'll leave it in the default VPC, the same as our instances. And we'll leave the standard storage class selected, and we'll just create our file system. There are more options if you want to customize the performance and other characteristics, but we'll just create. All right, so that is being created, and that will take a couple of minutes. Now, if we click on the file system and we come in here and then go to network, what you'll see is that it's creating these mount targets in all of these different availability zones. But there's also a DNS name here. Now, we're going to copy that DNS name and use it for our commands. So I have this document open. This is in the course download, which you find at the end of section 1 of the course. Unzip the file, and then in the code Amazon EFS directory, you'll find this document called amazonefscommands.md. What I need to do is delete out this DNS name here. So we should be left with just this colon and a slash, and then paste in the correct one. So now I have the correct ID for my file system. So make sure your document looks like this. We'll be using this shortly. Now we're going to run these commands in order. So I'll copy the first one. Let's go to EC2. I'm going to refresh the page. So I've got my two instances, and I'm going to open EC2 Instance Connect for each of these instances. So just open up Instance Connect for each one. And we're going to run the same commands on each instance. Okay, so let's paste in this command here. This is going to run the update manager. Do the same for the second instance. While that's happening, I'm going to go and get the other command. Let's come back to the first instance. There was nothing to update, which is good. Let's just make that directory. That's been done. And do the same for the second instance. Then we're going to install the EFS utils. So let's copy this command, go back to my first instance, paste the command. That's installing very quickly. Do the same for the second instance. So we're ready to mount now, but we need to do a couple of things first. So let's go back to EFS. Let's refresh the page. Now you can see that the security group is default, and we don't want that. We want to click on manage because we have our own security group. This one is not going to work. Now our instances are in US East 1A and B. So for ease, let's remove these other mount points. We don't need them. I'll get rid of the default security group, and then I'm going to add in EFS access to each of these. So now we've enabled the mount points only in the US East 1A and 1B availability zones, and we have a security group attached, and that security group will allow inbound access on the NFS port from the instances because they are in the security group. All right, let's go down and we're going to save this. And we now have the DNS name in our command, so we should be able to mount this file system. So back in the document, I'm going to copy the entire mount command, and I've already updated my DNS name, so it is correct. Let's come back to our first instance here, and I'm going to clear the screen and bring this down so you can see what's going on. Let's click on mount. And that's done. So the fact that we don't get an error message is good news. I'll do the same here. Let's run this command. And again, we've mounted the file system. So we should be able to change directory to the EFS mount point now and then create data there. And we should be able to see that data from the other instance. So we have our file system mounted. Now, if I change directory to the mount point, which should be in my current folder, so I can change directory to EFS mount point and then run ls. Of course, there's nothing in there. So what I'm going to do is run sudo make directory test directory. And now we have a directory, and I could run sudo touch test file. And then I have a file as well. Okay, so that's all I'm going to do. Just add a couple of things. And hopefully when we mount the directory from the instance in the other availability zone, it should see the same information. So back on my second instance, I'm going to change directory to the EFS mount point, run ls, and of course there are my files. So that's it. We have launched two instances and attached them to an EFS file system. And we can read and write data from multiple availability zones to the same EFS file system. So that's it for this lesson. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and I'm going to terminate my two instances. And then I'm going to also delete my EFS file system. So the instances are going down. Let's go back to EFS, click on file systems, select the file system, choose delete. And then we just need to enter the ID of the file system, which I can just copy from here, and then confirm. And that's it. That should start deleting fairly soon. Just keep an eye on it, make sure it does. And I will see you in the next lesson.